heart open that the Lord has us. So what I want you to do is just sort of forget that, you know, there's someone to either side of you right now. Mm-hmm. And just concentrate on His words. And I know it's probably most of you are going to still follow them in a bit. But God, why don't you come to the Bible? And we'll see this as loud as we can. Not obnoxiously loud, but just loud enough. And I want you to sing with us what all of us sing to the Lord. We're not singing to each other. We're just going to sing this song to the Lord Himself. Because it is a song to Him. It's saying, you know, who do I have in heaven but you? I mean, He's sort of answering us, isn't He, with the next phrase. So let's just join in and sing this song to the Lord and worship Him with it right now, all right? Generally, you know, we've seen a lot of what is going on in the body of Christ in the United States, and especially the southern United States, which is where we live. And then we've gotten such a broad view of what He wants to do all over, because we've seen New Zealand and part of Australia. And, you know, it's good that the Lord speaks the same thing to everyone at once, isn't it? And this is what we find is happening. And so, I want to ask Molly to sing, could you sing that solo song for a long time? I'm going to ask her to sing a song that she wrote herself, and I hope that you can hear it and listen to it. And if you would like to turn to Isaiah 60 in your Bible, since she'll be singing it, you can follow the paraphrase or whatever you have and get the real gist of it. And this would be Isaiah 60 verses 1, 2, and 3. And this is really a word that we swear the Lord is speaking to you folks today too, along with the rest of the body of Christ. And the word is this, Isaiah wrote, "Arise and shine, for thy light is come. The glory of the Lord is rising in the sun," the S-O-N, Jesus the Son of God. And He says that Gentiles will come to this light, and that even though darkness may cover the earth, there's going to be a people that shine forth this light or reflect the glory of God to such an extent that other people are drawn to that thing, you see. And that's what the Lord wants to get across to the whole body of Christ in this time. He's going to take us to a point in which He manifests Himself within each of us, and people see the righteousness, peace, and joy that we have, which is the kingdom of God and the Holy Ghost, and they're going to be drawn to that kingdom, you see. And so this is just a call to the body of Christ to arise and to begin to shine forth that which has been given to us. So, Molly, would you minister to us with that song?
The Lord shall arise and shine for all to see, and His glory shall be seen upon thee. And that really expresses something that David and I are beginning to see universally as we climb it throughout the body of Christ. It's a thrilling thing to begin to see a people who will come together in unity and love and begin to arise and shine forth the light of the Lord Jesus Christ. feeling that the faces of all these people who are shining for us today, but if you're not smiling, Mother, I want you to. Face up to the fact that he wants to do something within us to show forth the world
His glory. You see, I mean, he's not looking for anyone else. He's looking for you. So we're going to sing this chorus about maybe three more times. And now the first time we sing it, I want us to sing, "The Lord shall arise and shine for all to see, and his glory shall be seen upon me." All right, we're going to change the V to me to make it more personal. And I want you just to point your finger to yourself and just remind yourself that it's you that God wants to do something in. And then the second time, I want you to go back to the V at the end and point to the person next to you, because we are the body of Christ and we corporately build each other up, all right? And this is going to be like putting a little mortar between the stones, and we're going to remind each other that it's also you, it's we, that the Lord wants to manifest himself in. And then the third time through, we'll sing it and we'll point to the person on our right. So it'll be ourself, and then left, and then right. Okay? And this is chorus in no verse. Well, just let the Lord emphasize this to you by his own spirit, okay?
Thank you. delegation from the table over the table just before, who assured me that they couldn't remember being called at all for first time round. So I think they have. I'm sure I saw them once. So yeah, sorry about that. But just to say that we haven't done any animosity, they can go first time. Just one moment. I haven't been to and somebody suggested Mr. Sam goes first for coming.
And I was reading this morning when I was doing the pictures.
Oh, I was playing in the boat.
See you with this time.
Oh, myself most of the time.
You didn't have guys racing around.
No.
Yeah, I wouldn't have minded going up in the boat with you, but the time is I had to do the pictures.
Can you kill the job?
Yeah. I doubt that one did for the killing.
Yeah.
There's a piece around birds that it takes just about all morning to do them.
Potatoes
are terrible for killing. Yeah. And, when you came back, what happened? When you came back from the
boat,
then?
We used to see this pretty soon after that.
Did you and I do the tape recording before then?
Oh, yes, I think we did.
What do you think of those American people? What were their names again?
David and Molly Thompson.
Yeah, okay. Who's this? Well, who's here to mad at Rainford? What's Rainford's first name? Jim. I'll see you later. Bring it out service. And, it's Mr. Rainford. In case you're thinking that Mr. Speaks Pete. Is there meant to be too long? It was Mr. Lane, not Mr. Speak. Just imagine that it was Mr. Speak.
Yeah.
You know what Mr. Speak is like?
Yes, I do.
His tongue is miles long, isn't it?
Mm.
What do you think of Mr. Speak?
Oh, no, he does speak too long.
Yeah.
No, I haven't even spoken to him.
No. I think he has learned a lot in the last year, so he has had a turn his down the size, but still, he's a little bit. He's very good, but I think his tongue just needs a little bit of tinning. Just imagine Mr. Sleep is born without a tongue, dude.
Oh, yeah. I don't know what he'll do. Write it down on paper.
Yeah.
And big notice.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, the service that we do, we went to what we did.
After the service.
We went to Camp Adair, didn't we?
Oh, yes, and I just recorded a bit of noise.
Like my camps have been trying to get off.
And someone screaming. Like this. Oh, when did we swap those scents?
Straight after
lunch?
No, straight after Camp Adair before lunch.
Oh, yes. Swapped out a few scents.
Did you get some good ones there?
That's pretty good. Did you get some good ones?
Yeah. You see that? Yeah, first shot I've done for ages. First shot I've done for years.
Well, I never do shot. Except today.
Yeah. Still using the boat. The guy and young just came through and they're bringing them in now. Yes. I know one thing wrong with this camp, Derek.
What?
Too short.
Yeah.
Do you think of anything else wrong with this camp?
Not the moment.
No.
Two mugs here.
Mugs at Murray Thompson and the like.
Yeah.
Anyway, we had a good jump for dinner.
Mm-hmm. Had a second helping?
Yeah, and thanks for tag Mr. Marshall. I had to hunt for my cameras.
Finally found them in your cabin, didn't you?
Yeah, I think tag Marshall. I didn't put them there. Somebody, presumably Marshall, got my cameras. Well, that's probably why you and I were shopping stamps. I took it down to my cabin, but I found the cameras in somebody else's bed.
No, it was in the lunch time.
Yeah, probably.
I noticed him running out the door with something, but I didn't realize what it was.
No. right up through and through that in the microphone.
Mm.
And then you know what happened after lunch?
What do you know?
You know what? Horrible. No, I think we'll lose the camp photo.
Oh.
That one taking photos of me taking a camp photo. And then me and Lee came to the horrible part of camp. What part of camp did you like to be a third?
Oh, well, when I was, I think the bait was, baits were quite good, but me and David Holden wasn't strong, they weren't so good at me.
That's right, when I, after breakfast, after Christmas, when I came out and I was hunting around for you, there you were sort of feeling not so very pleased with yourself.
No, well, I got put in a box and I had another place with a big lump of shit.
That's no good.
Wasn't. Also, that was in my last, I had my last clothes on, I got absolutely soaked.
Yeah. Just Colin kind of Barford popped with your face for the same thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
We're recording,
you know?
We're recording.
We're just recording conversation.
Okay.
And how did you enjoy the camp, boys? Imagine this time last year, Joe, if we were recording like this, and a big cop came along and told us to tell me that Peter Hart was ready to take me home. Remember that, Joe? No, it's Michael Scarlett.
Yeah.
Actually, Michael Scarlett was there, remember?
Yeah. Michael Scarlett before.
Michael Scarlett, you and I called him.
Well, he
just
took
a day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Hi, Dave. David. David, welcome. David, how did you enjoy the camp?
Who's that?
David. Well, David, what did you think of the camp? What did you think of the camp, Dave?
Okay.
What part did you like the best?
I didn't.
What part did you like the best? Didn't you like the camp at all?
Did
you like the boat for being teased about the part or the trampoline or the hike or what? There's one thing wrong with this camp, do you know how to teach?
It's too short,
really. Too short. It should be longer.
Probably
you people got jail tomorrow and I've got to play around with the RRA buses again tomorrow.
What do you do?
Pardon?
What do you do?
What do you mean?
What do you do?
Okay. What's your name again?
Yeah.
Still going to be driving me home, and he's still sitting down enjoying the sun, enjoying the shadow. So it's this camp anyway. Here you come, son.
What camp?
This one.
Which one?
This one, Grandpa.
This one, what camp? Haven't been in the camp.
This one. What about you, Johnny?
Thank you.
Thank you.